Hey everybody, welcome to another exciting episode of Data Exposed. I'm your host, Scott Klein, with me, back by popular demand.
Yeah.
Yeah, Liam Cavanagh.
Hey, thanks for having me again.
Good, how are you doing?
This is great. I love the new studios. I know you've had it for a while, but man, this is beautiful. I don't know which camera to look at. This is really cool.
It's about a month we've had this.
Wow, so awesome. Yeah, it's been that long.
Yeah. So Liam's here because we were just walking down the hall and I ran into him and he's like, dude, let's do a show. I'm like, I got some availability. Come on by.
So we just got it going. We'll see how this goes.
Yeah, all right. Let's see how this goes. So obviously you're here to talk about search.
That's right.
But search is as far as the, what are we talking about?
So we got a couple of new things. So it's been a while since we've been here. So, you know, one of the things I wanted to go through is not only some of the analytics that you can do, but one of the other cool features called synonyms that we've added. Some of the uses and the reasons why you might want to do that.
Okay. Sweet. All right. Let's go.
Shall we do it? Okay. So what I have here is a search service, and this is a real estate data set that we created. It's 5 million listings of randomly created listings with descriptions, geolocation around the U.S. So it's a pretty cool data set to use. But what I thought I'd do is use this as a basis to show how we can make use of something called synonyms.
Okay.
Which is the idea, like if you think about what people are searching for, you know, it's not always an exact match to what is actually in my...
That's all right. Mine just went off, so we'll just keep
going. Ignore that. So what people are searching for is not always an exact match to what you have in your content.
Right.
So what I want to do is through both the analytics as well as the synonyms, show how we can start adding this customized dictionary so that as people start searching for those words, you can match them to the right content.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Okay.
Very good.
So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to tie it into Power BI.
Okay.
And if you just click on services here, what we can do is we can link into our Azure Search service where we are actually logging the information. So if I go down just a little bit here, you'll see that Azure Search is one of the entries here.
Okay.
I'm going to choose Get.
Yep.
And so what it's going to do is I'm going to say, okay, where are you actually logging all of your search operations?
Okay.
So the way that I find that is by just going into here and under All Settings.
Into your search service.
Yep. So from my search service.
Yep.
We have this thing called Search Traffic Analytics.
Okay.
And all you need to do is you just need to specify an Azure storage account for where you're going to log this. So it's completely optional whether you log the metrics such as, you know, latency, number of queries, as well as the operations. So what this is going to do in a second is just come back and give me my storage account for where this is actually going to be logged.
Okay.
So we'll give that a second. It's taking a second to connect in here. There we go.
There we go.
So we see here I have a storage account called AZ Search Real Estate, and I'm logging up to 120 days of search queries, as well as all the metrics for up to 120 days. And so that's what I'm going to connect to. And by the way, if anyone actually wants to give this a try, I've made this storage account publicly accessible, so you can just you know, put in 120 days worth of data. I can put AZ Search Real Estate. Hopefully I typed that right. And if it was a private one, it would ask me for my credentials to actually allow Power BI to connect into it. Since it's public, it's just going to go in, connect, start importing all of that historical data, and we have some pretty nice dashboards that allow you to visualize, you know, what's happening and, you know, go into a lot of the data. So we'll give this another second to load up. And what we'll see in this is not only things like what are the most common search requests that are coming in, but also probably even more importantly, what are people searching for but not finding results, not getting any data.
Okay.
So let's see if this comes up here. So what we were talking about is this idea that, you know, if we can see here what people are searching for, you know, here are the most common search queries.
Yep.
But you'll notice here in the search results, there is, if we look into it, there's something called Hashas Key, which I don't know what that is, but let's find it out. If we type it up, Hashas Key, let's see what comes up here. So this is some sort of high-end, you know, appliance. So apparently what happens is when people search for real estate, you know, they'll not only search for addresses, locations, but they'll look for attributes for that real estate site. So, you know, in this particular case, this person was interested in a house that had this type of appliance, but realistically what they probably mean is they really want to have, you know, a home that has a high-end appliance in it.
Right.
So in fact, if we actually give this a try here, go back to my Postman tool.
Okay.
You know, this is nice for being able to do search queries. I can search for everything. I can search for homes in Seattle.
Yeah.
I can do this Ozaki here, and as you can see, just as we expected, there's no results.
Right. Okay.
So how do we fix this? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create something called a synonym map. And it's just a really dictionary of different words that we can say that if somebody types in this word, here are the different variations to it. If you see these variations in it, that's a good result. So you can see here I have a synonym map called Real Estate Synonyms. And I'm going to add in, you know, not only this word, but a number of other different high-end appliances that can all map to, you know, the word high-end appliance in there. So I can create that synonym map. So now the Azure Search service has that dictionary, and you can keep updating it. You can keep loading in more synonyms.
So as you learn about, you know, as new, you know, high-end appliances, or you learn more about the, you know, the differences, you can come in and modify the your synonym.
Exactly, and that's why this, you know, this page right here is so handy, because I can keep refreshing it. You know, every once in a while, check for what are the common search terms. You know, and it could be changing, right? You can just see, you know, what's new, and then come back and update that. So I've created the synonym map, and all I need to do is link it to a specific field. So for example, if I get my index here, I can just get the schema of the index. And by the way, this is a preview feature. Uh-huh. So all of this has to be done today through the API. We haven't brought it into the portal yet.
Okay.
But you can see here, if I go down to my description field, what I can do is I can create this synonym map right here, and refer to it by name right here. So whenever I send that in and create the apply that, now when I start doing searches using that word, we're going to get the viable results that come back from this. So now, not when I type in this word, we can see that somewhere stainless steel or high end, you know, any of those matches are going to come in. So you can see how we can start tuning this more and more using this very simple tool.
That is awesome.
Thanks, Scott.
So right now you have to do this through the APIs.
That's right.
But pretty soon you'll be able to do all this mapping and things right through the portal.
Yeah, that's the idea. So the Preview API is kind of our experimental platform where we can put out these new features and allow the customers to give them a try, you know, give us feedback. And then as we have it solid, we can move it into the official API and then allow you to then use it in the portal.
So did this come about because you had a lot of people going, you know what, I'm not getting a lot of results from my searches, even though, you know, Azure Search is awesome. We're not getting, I'm typing this, I'm looking for X, but I'm not getting any results.
Yeah,
that's
exactly right. I mean, there's all kinds of different ways that people look at getting relevant results. You know, we've done things like handling the spelling mistakes, you know, doing phonetic search, so words that sound similar. But something like this is just a different variation, and we see it across every different industry. Think about in the medical field. Think of all the different variations for drug names that there are, that they want, and it's very specific to their industry. Mm-hmm. So they need to provide their own dictionary and put it in. So yeah, this has been one of the top requests, and so I'm happy to finally have this in the
this
service.
Is, yeah, this is great, and I think this will make just the service better as we, you know, across the services, right?
Yeah,
cool.
Agreed.
Well, awesome.
Thanks very much,
huh? All right, Liam, thanks for coming. All right, we look forward to having you back to talk about other cool stuff that you guys are thinking of brainstorming over there. Hey, thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you next time.